And if anything was to happen, which could, which probably, if anything was to happen financially to us, at least a lot of these men and women will have a secondary home to go to and apply the craft. In other words, if, let's say, like I said, if TNA was to go out silently into the night, people like Kurt Angle, Bram, EC3, you know, Matt Morgan, he's back. Magnus, as I just mentioned, James Storm, Bobby Roode, Eric Young, you know, Austin Aries, the Wolves, they would all have a place to go if anything was to happen to TNA Wrestling. So, that's what I think this whole situation with GFW is. That's why Jeff came back the way he did. Not only to go out the way he wants to in the ring one last time, but I think, in a sense, to help TNA out and help the talent, you know, at least have a place, or at least help the talent and let them know that if anything does happen to this company, to TNA, that they will always have a place, they will have a place to go to afterwards, no questions asked, in Global Force Wrestling. Now, that could be what happens. That could be the reason for this. And if it's a merger, I could see Global Force Wrestling, mostly TNA, not only merging, but being absorbed into Global Force Wrestling and Impact Wrestling becoming Global GFW Impact Wrestling. Instead of being a TNA Impact Wrestling, it'll be GFW Impact Wrestling. And a lot of the tapings for that Impact would take place in Las Vegas. I could see that. I mean, these are just some potential scenarios with this situation going on with TNA and GFW. I could see that. I could see that really happening. I really can. Because I want you to notice something. When GFW Wrestling's YouTube channel documented Jeff Jarrett's return to TNA Wrestling, they showed him interacting with certain TNA stars. These are the certain TNA stars that I think will have a home in Global Force Wrestling. I'm just saying. Well, these will be the first few, like Magnus, that he'll be eyeing. But again, that's just my opinion. But I think that that's what's, in my opinion, and honestly, just my opinion, I think this is honestly what's going on. I can't shake the feeling that that's what this is all about. That TNA is basically working with GFW to allow their talent to have a place to go if anything happens to the company. Which means a lot of these pay-per-views that they have, like Slammiversary, Bound for Glory, Lockdown, Genesis, Victory Road, you name it, will all end up going under the GFW banner if a merger is going to happen and TNA gets absorbed into GFW. And everything TNA-wise, from Explosion, Impact Wrestling, all ends up under the GFW banner. Again, it's just speculation and just my opinion, but there's got to be more than just, you know, exchange of talent. There's got to be more than just him appearing for a one-match return to go out the way he wants. You know, there's got to be more to it, and obviously, you know, with reports that Magnus is going to be allowed to appear on some events with GFW, as well as maybe the TV tapings. You know, I mean, I just have this feeling this is what we could be seeing in the near future. And perhaps this is what could be what saves TNA's situation with Destination America and changes Destination America's mind. So, but we'll just have to wait and see what happens. But again, it's just speculation on my part. But that's what happens when you see something like this occur. When you see something you would not think what's going to happen, something totally unannounced happen, and you see somebody that obviously you thought would never come back to a company he founded and has already gone and founded his own company and has already done a few of his own live events in the ballparks and all that, and is even associated with all these other promotions, come back the way he did. I mean, you can't just help but to speculate and think of what could be and give your own opinions on what the possibilities are. So Let me know what you guys think down below. Deluxe Man, I would love to hear your video response on this, because I know you would have a lot to say on it. But let me know what you guys think down below. Chase Oliver, I'd like to hear from you. OTR Central, anybody watching. So, that's all I'm going to say, folks. Let me know what you guys think down below. Give me your thoughts and opinions on it. And I'll talk to y'all later.